Yes. Oyster. Yes. Famous for their powers of seduction.
Come on camera so we can stop this in.
We'll show them just how much they mean to you. Welcome to the Awkward High School Dance. Live.
I'm dancing, man. Let's go.
Okay. Here to give us a lesson in dancing and the proper way to shuck oysters and some alternative ways to serve them up is Adam Calhoun from Oyster Boy and Chef Kyle Deliri as well. Thank you both for joining us this morning to teach us the proper way. And these actually are aphrodisiacs.
Absolutely.
Let's get that one out of the way right now.
First of all, good morning, Roger.
Good morning.
Thanks
morning,
for
morning.
Having us on the show.
Thanks for the dance too, Chef.
Are properly scientifically proven to have aphrodisiac qualities. It's two amino acids that increase the testosterone in the male and testosterone in the female.
Okay.
Scientifically proven. So there's no more any doubt. It's not a myth. Oysters are aphrodisiacs, the perfect food for Valentine's Day.
Oh,
so come on down to Oyster Boy.
Yes.
So first things first, let's say we go buy some oysters and want to do it ourselves.
Surely.
So what am I looking for?
Oyster Boy is 872 Queen Street West, and you can come and pick up oysters to take home in one of our lovely bags. You don't have to buy a box. You can buy 6 or 12 or 18 oysters to shuck in the privacy of your own home. And Oyster Boy has been around for 29 years.
And that doesn't get
one of the main things I've always taught or thought is to teach people how to shuck.
Yeah.
Because they're going to a restaurant, you're paying $3 or $4 or $5 an oyster. If you shuck it at home, you can buy it at a reputable retailer like Oyster Boy. And you're paying $1 an oyster or $1.05, you're paying a third the price.
Yeah. More bang for your buck. So let's get started. How do we shuck?
So we have the oysters here. We're shucking some Newfoundland oysters, which is brand new.
Yeah.
This is the first time that Newfoundland oysters have been on TV in Toronto.
Oh, wow.
So
really?
It's pretty cool.
Why are they suddenly coming in?
The water's too cold in Newfoundland. The oysters won't breed. So what Juan Roberts is doing is he's bringing in the seed from New Brunswick, and he's growing them in Maritime Bay.
Oh, cool.
And
inventive.
They're awesome oysters. He's been trying for 8 years, and now we have the beautiful oysters. They're really good and salty because they're right in the Atlantic Ocean. So Newfoundland is the only Atlantic province, and now we have oysters from them. So we have oysters from the Maritime provinces, oysters from BC, and we have now oysters from Newfoundland, which is pretty cool.
Okay.
And we're
going to
try
the banjo shucking knife. This is made by my cousin in Prince Edward Island. And exactly. It's Prince Edward Island.
It's the only banjo song I know.
How do we hold it properly?
So you hold it like this, so your index finger is on the blunt side of the knife, and the edge of the knife is here, the edge of the sword, I call it.
And apparently, it's great to be left-handed. Finally,
yes.
A benefit to being left-handed is this. Why?
God, in her ultimate wisdom, made oysters left-handed. So she was smiling on all left-handers when she made oysters.
So I'll be able to open this faster than you then.
It's a bit, if we're both like proper professional oyster shuckers and we're going head-to-head, you would save an eighth of a second on each oyster.
Perfect.
Yes.
So you have a cutting board, you have a towel so that it's got a steady place.
Let's just show this for a second.
Is it a wet towel? Yep. No, just a towel.
Just a towel. The towel is to ramp the oyster up on a 45-degree angle. And we want to have the thin part of the oyster, that's the hinge, the narrow part. We want to have that facing up, surely.
So you want the narrowest part facing up on a 45-degree angle.
Yep.
And flat facing up, or sort of flat.
Well, kind of like 45-degree angle. That way, if you miss, you're on a 45-degree angle, your knife is going down, not into your hand.
Oh, that's good advice.
Yeah.
I like
that.
So here we go. We got it all ramped up. And then we're going in the hinge. It's actually a proper spot there for the knife that just sits there. So it's a little space there for the knife to get through. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be stretching the adductor muscle, which is the only moving part of the oyster. It's the muscle that holds the two shells together. An oyster is a bivalve in the mollusk family. And what we're going to do is we're just going to stretch, and that's it. That's the shuck right there.
That's it?
Yep. And then what we do is we use our fingers.
Okay, I got half the shuck there.
And we come down here and sever the top part of the adductor muscle from the top part of the shell.
Okay.
And then because I'm right-handed, I have to go 180 degrees. So we release the oyster from the bottom part
Beautiful.
Of the shell.
Beautiful. Let's talk about some of the things we have here, Chef.
All right.
Should we start with the bait?
Yes.
Let's start with the bake, shall we?
We have three varieties of baked oysters. We have Rockefeller, which are the green ones, with spinach, fennel, and Parmesan with a bechamel. And then we have our bacon balsamic with Gruyere on top and breadcrumbs. And our Rustico, which are spicy, made with Tabasco and Gruyere.
And how long, if you're going to bake them, how long do you bake them for?
We go for about 11 minutes, 500 degrees.
Okay. Wow, okay, high heat and quick.
What do you have there, Chef?
Lobster mac and cheese.
And on, you have a fried oyster option.
Yes, our deep-fried oysters with horseradish mayo, and they're delicious.
Are certain oysters better for certain things? Like if you're going to do a baked oyster, is there a certain type of oyster that's better for it?
I would steer towards West Coast with the baked oysters, such a predominant flavor. And then you got other, like, spicy, it just makes everything balance out nice.
Mm. Okay.
There you go. So let's grab an oyster, and sure, these are the toppings. You have your homemade seafood
seafood sauce.
Here,
what's
chef. This? This
you is can like have a, my first chef.
Red wine vinegar with chopped shallots.
Now I got to be honest. These aren't my favorite things. What's this? This is spicy?
That's a hot pepper with ginger and garlic.
Okay. Now, how do you eat these? Do you slurp it or do you chew it?
So what I do, because I love oysters, is I always like to eat the oyster by itself.
Yeah.
Because then I get the mineral.
Horseradish?
But if you have sauce, yeah, you just take it. It's got a natural cup shape. You bring it up to your mouth.
You slurp it? No noise.
Give it a little too.
Is there a toast or a cheers you do
sauce
for it?
The sauce is delicious.
Okay, cheers. So it sucks itself back on the shell a bit, right?
And you're kind enough. You're not being shellfish. Hey, oh, you're sharing. See what I did there? If you want to go to Oyster Boy, there's a reason why celebs love to go there. They have the freshest oysters in town. You're located on Queen Street West.
Sorry, chef.
You have a dinner certificate for two. So yes, qualify to enter. Go to breakfasttelevision.ca and click on Daily Prizing. Good luck, everybody. Go for it, Raj.
All right. There you go.
The toppings are delicious.
Yeah. That's all you need.
You like it?